Welcome, everybody. We're here in Grandfalls, Texas. I'm here for the junior high game versus Grandfalls Royalty. And there's about 4 minutes till the start of the game. And please share the feed. Let them know we'll be going over both games this evening, both the junior high game and the varsity game here in Grandfalls. Well, welcome to the Red Devil Network. We're here in Grand Falls, and today we have the Rankin Junior High Lady Devils going against Grand Falls Royalty. And the Rankin roster is number 1, Alezra; number 2, Arlie; number 12, Giselle; number 15, Paige; number 18, Addison; number 21, Jesse; number 24, Brinley; and number 25, Brianna. And those are the girls on the Lady Devils. We're going to start in about 1 minute. And joining us tonight will be Boo Boo Bear. He'll be here briefly. And we'll have one camera tonight here in Grand Falls. And then immediately following this game, we'll be showing the varsity girls as they take on in-district action Grand Falls. And they were victorious over Grand Falls when they played earlier this year. And so that was one of our district wins. All right, getting ready for some game action. Our junior high girls have done outstanding this year. And they're getting ready on play, to play Grandfalls Royalty. And if you're listening in, spread the message that we are broadcasting this evening here from Grandfalls. And the junior high Lady Devils are 5-1 on the year. They've 6-1. So they have a great record, done fantastic this year in volleyball. Again, the roster is number 1, Alezra, number 2, Arlie, number 12, Giselle, number 15, Paige, number 18, Addison, number 21, Jesse, number 24, Brindley, and number 25, Brianna. Coaches are Coach Botlin and Coach John Bright. And now we're getting ready to start. And it looks like Rankin will be serving first. And first up to the line, I think, will be Arlie for the Lady Devils. And they're checking the rosters on the court. Arlie at the line, number 2 for the Lady Devils. She gets a good serve over the net. It is set by Grand Falls, and they knock it over, fielded by Arlie. And then it was hit by number 1, Alezra, but a little bit short. And the first point will go to the home team. We'll go to Grand Falls. It goes to Arlie, to Alezra, and then to Addison, but it doesn't get over the net, and so it'll be 2-0 Grand Falls now. Number 15 for Grand Falls is serving, and her first serve is pretty good. She serves again. It's played by Arlie to Alezra. Then it falls to the court, and so Grand Falls gets an early lead, and it's now 3-0 here in this first game in Grand Falls. Addison hits it, and then Brianna hits it over the net. But unfortunately, she gets into the net just a little bit, so that'll be a point, Grand Falls. Now it's 4-0. Grand Falls is getting an early lead in this first game. Number 18, Addison hits it, and then number 25, Brianna gets it over the net. Grand Falls gets it back over. Brindley hits it again to Brianna. Brianna over the net. It's back and forth. We've got a pretty good rally here. Addison to Brianna. Back over the net. Grand Falls hits it twice. Number 9 gets it back over the net. Back to Rankin's side. Arlie hits it, but then it goes out of bounds. A little bit too much mustard on the ball. And now it's a 5-0 game. And number 15 for Grand Falls, still serving. This will be her fourth serve. Arlie hits it to Brianna. Brianna gets it over the net. It's played well by number 1 from Grand Falls. They get it. It's number 1, Alezra. And Alezra hits it to Brianna. Brianna hits it over the net, but it's blocked by Grand Falls. So that'll be a point, Grand Falls, 6-0 now. Ball is hit by Brianna. She hits it over the net. Great play there by number 25, Brianna, and that will be a point, Lady Devils, breaking the streak. Now it's 6-1. As Rankin comes to serve, that's number 12, Giselle. Giselle hits it to Grand Falls with a good serve there by number 12, Giselle. And that'll be a point, Lady Devils, 6-2 now. Giselle serves it, and Grand Falls gets it back, and then Giselle knocks it back over the net, then to Arlie. Arlie hits it to Brindley. Number 18, Addison, gets it back over the net. And that's a good play by number 18, Addison, for the Lady Devils. And that'll be point Lady Devils. 6-3 now is the score. Sale gets a serve in. Grandfalls plays it twice, but they're going to call a lift call against Grandfalls. And so Rankin coming back. It is 6-4. They're behind by two as Giselle from the service line. She hits it a little bit short and outside. So now the score is 7-4. Grandfalls on top of the Lady Devils here in Grandfalls. Grandfall serves it, and Rankin's able to get it over. Addison gets it over the net. Then they're able to hit it right down the line. It's a good play by Grand Falls. And that brings up to the serving line number two for Grand Falls at the 8-4 ball game. Grand Falls on top. Giselle hits it to Arlie. Arlie chased it down but was unable to get there. It'll be point Grand Falls, 9-4 is the score. Grand Falls hits it. It's fielded by number one, Elezra. Elezra to Arlie. And Arlie hits it to Brindley. Brindley hits it a little short, so it'll be point Grand Falls. Elezra hits it to Brindley, hits it. And then Brianna gets it over the net. Nice play, but it goes just out by a few inches. Nice hit by number 25, Brandon, but it goes just out. And it'll be 11-4 now. Grandfall still serving. Got a 7-point lead as timeout is called. It's been a beautiful day today. Fall weather is finally here. I think it was 100 degrees Sunday afternoon. And much cooler today. Getting ready for a great week of school. And had a Lady Devils faced a powerful Wink team Saturday afternoon. And unfortunately did not get the W, but experienced some really good volleyball at the Devils' Den on Saturday afternoon. Saturday evening, Rankin Red Devils played Calvert. And played a great ball game. We were successful against the Calvert Trojans Saturday night. All right, we're coming back to action after the timeout. It's 11-4 game. Grand Falls got the early lead by 7 points. Let's see if the Lady Devils can dig out and get this game, steal this game against Grand Falls. Number two, serving. She's going to serve it deep. Fielded by Arlie. Arlie to Brianna. Brianna hits it over with a nice hit, aggressive hit there by 25. Brianna, and that'll be a score. Lady Devils, now it's 11-5 ball game. And going to the service line for the Lady Devils is number 25, Brianna. She does an underhand serve, gets it in, and has too much spice for number two, so great serve there by number 25, Brianna, and that'll be another point. Lady Devils, 11-6, closing the gap. Brianna serves it again. It's fielded in the back row by Grand Falls. They are able to get it over. A little bit of miscommunication by the Lady Devils. The ball falls to the court, and that'll be point Grand Falls, 12-6 game, as number 10 for Grand Falls goes to the service line. She hits it hard and deep. It goes to the back row. Giselle tries to field it, but had a little bit too much spice for her, so that'll be point Grand Falls. So now it's a 13-6 ball game. Again, a 7-point spread. It's hit hard, overhead serve by Grand Falls. Arlie hits it, Giselle, and it is nicely played by number 18, Addison. What a play by Addison, number 18 for the Lady Devils. And that'll be point for Rankin. So now it's a 13-7 ball game as number 24, Brindley, comes to serve. Number 24, Brindley, serves it nicely right down the line, and that's going to be an ace. Lady Devils, nicely done by Brindley. And now it's a 13-8 ball game. It's a five-point spread. And number 24, Brindley, is at the service line. Brindley serves it again with a nice serve, great placement. And it's too much to handle for Grand Falls, and that'll be another point after another great serve by number 24, Brindley, for the Lady Devils. Now it's a 13-9 ball game here in this first game of three. Number 24, Brindley, serves it again, nice and low and hard, and it is too hard to handle for Grand Falls. And the number 24 tearing it up from the service line. It is 13-10. As number 24, Brindley, is serving great. Brindley hits it again, hits it high into the back row. Grand Falls hits it from the back row, but it falls short of the net. Now it's a 13-11 and a two-point spread in this first of three. And that causes a Grand Falls timeout after some great serves by number 24, Brindley. Back to game action after that timeout by Grand Falls. It's a 13-11 ball game. Number 24, Brindley, serving really well for the Lady Devils. And she gets another great serve, and it is too much to handle for number 9. And number 24, Brindley, is on fire for the Lady Devils. Now it's a one-point spread, 13-12. Brindley hits it again. This is a howling field in the back row. Grand Falls is going to make a couple of good plays on it, but they cannot get it over the net. And that's going to tie this game up at 13. And Lady Devils were as far back as 8 points at one time, and now they have dug all the way back to tie this game up. Thanks largely to number 24, Brindley, from the service line. Good, hard, spicy serve, and that's going to be an ace for Brindley from the service line. Lady Devils up now. First lead for the Lady Devils in this game. And she hits it again. It's going to be played in the back row, but too much spice again. And Brindley's been really impressive today. 15-13, Lady Devils now have the lead by 2 points. Number 24, Brindley from the service line. Here she goes. Hits it low and into the top of the net. But what a great series of serves from Brindley for the Red Devils. And we have a substitute, number 21, Jesse, is going to come in for Brindley and play in the back row for the Lady Devils. It's a 15-14 ball game, and number 14 from Grand Falls will be at the service line. Number 14, right up, she serves it to Jesse, who just subbed in, played it nicely. And then that is Addison that knocks it over the net. And Grand Falls is getting it back, and they're trying to get it back. It hits the ceiling and does not go over. So that'll be a point, Lady Devils. It's 16-14 now, and number 18, Addison, goes to the line for the Lady Devils. The stands are full here in Grand Falls. Addison does an overhead serve with lots of spin. Great serve by Addison. Wow, a very impressive serve. Overhead serve by number 18, Addison, with a little bit of top spin on it. It was too hard to handle for Grand Falls, so that'll be point Lady Devils. Now it's a 17-14 game. Lady Devils on top by three. Addison hits another doozy there with a little top spin, overhead serve. Too much to handle for Grand Falls. She hits it overhanded and puts a little top spin on it, so it comes down and it comes off their arms wrong if they don't hit it just right. So great serving by number 18, Addison. It's 18-14 game, 4-point spread, as Addison's still at the service line. Good, another hard serve, overhead serve with top spin. And that'll be another point, Lady Devils. 19-14 is the score. Addison hits it deep. It's going to be played by the back row, but it's going to be an ace. Another ace for the Lady Devils, and that's 18 Addison serving it overhead with top spin, doing a great job. Now it's a 20-14 game, 6-point spread. Addison hits it, it's filled in the front row over the net. Played nicely there by Grand Falls. That will be a point, Grand Falls. After some great serves by Addison for the Lady Devils, it's 20-15 ball game, 5-point spread as number 13 comes to the service line for Grand Falls. And she's going to hit it overhead with a little spin, and it doesn't quite make its way over the net, so that'll be your point, Lady Devils. 21-15, and the magic number is 25. They're looking to get to 25. They have to win by two. It's 21-15 right now. And that's number eight serving the ball. Number one, excuse me, Alezra. Alezra does a nice underhanded serve. Grand Falls trying to get it over, and they do. Played by Alezra to Arlie. And they're going to call a lift. And that'll be a point for Grand Falls Royalty. And that'll bring them to 16. So 21-16, Lady Devils on top as number one for Grand Falls comes to the service line. Number one hits it hard with toss spin overhand. Great serve. Lady Devils handle it well. Get it over by number 12. Giselle get it with a nice play. Grand Falls gets it back, and then Rankin's unable to handle it after the return. So now it's a 21-17. Again, the gap is getting closing down by a little bit. Here we go. Red Devils try to field a tough serve by number one, are unable to do so. So now it's 21-18. Grand Falls serving here in this first game. And they're going to hit it to the back row. Rankin fields it, gets it over the net, and they will get the point here. Nicely done by the Lady Devils. Under pressure after that nice serve, the Lady Devils handle it nicely and end up getting the point. Now it's 22-18 as number two, Arlie, comes to the line. And Arlie does an overhead serve with a spin, and it is too much to handle. Now, instead of a little top spin, she has a little bit of side spin, I noticed. So, Arlie putting a little English on the ball. Number two from the service line, 23-18. She surges to the back row, and it is too much to handle. And that'll be 24-18, and that'll be game point Lady Devils in this first game. Arlie, number two, at the service line, and a timeout is called. And we'll see what happens when we come out as the Lady Devils doing a great job in this first game and have game point. Mm-hmm. All right, here we go. It is game point. Arlie's at the line. She gets a good serve. Grandfalls trying to get it over, and they do not. And that will be the first game. We'll go to the Lady Devils after some great serving. And the one that dug us out of the hole early was Brindley, and then a couple back-to-back, Addison, and then Arlie all did a tremendous job from the service line, bringing the Lady Devils back after they fell almost by 8 points early in this first game of action. But they handled adversity really well and started serving and were able to pull back in and win that game. And so first game of three goes to the Lady Devils. We're going to start game two. It's a 0-0 starting game two, and Rankin Lady Devils were victorious in the first game. Grandfalls starts the show. Brindley hits it to Addison. Addison to Brianna. Brianna gets it over the net, and it's a nice play all the way around for the Lady Devils. Good teamwork right there, and Brianna is able to get over the net with a little spice and everything nice, and Grandfalls could not handle it. So it's a one-point lead here to start the second game as Arlie comes to the line to serve. And Arlie hits it a little low. Unfortunately, it doesn't go over the net. And that'll be point. Grand Falls royalty. So it's a 1-1 affair here in the second game after Lady Devils won the first one. Number two headed to the service line for Grand Falls royalty. Underhand serve. Gets it to the back row. Arlie takes it to Brindley. Brindley's going to get it over. Grandfalls knocks it over, but it's nicely played by Lesra. Unfortunately, we couldn't get it to it, but A one-arm hit by Lezra, number one for the Lady Devils. But that will be point Grandfalls. So now it's a 2-1 game as number one. Number two is at the service line. She does an underhand serve. Arlie fields it, and then Brianna knocks it over. Grandfalls is going to hit it twice, and an overhand slam from the back row, but it's fielded by Lezra to Arlie. To Brianna back over the net, and too much to handle for Grandfalls. Good teamwork by the Lady Devils there. And that'll tie things up at two here in Grand Falls in the second game. All right. That's number 12 at the service line, Giselle. Giselle hits it with a nice serve. Too hard to handle for Grand Falls. So Giselle starts the show with the rink inside with a great serve. And that'll be point Lady Devils 3-2 in this game. Giselle still serve underhanded but hits it to the back row. Fielded by Grand Falls. They get it over the net. And number 18, Addison hits it, but then it's too much to hit for Brindley, and it falls to the court, and that'll be a point 3-3 in this tied affair here in the second game, and Lady Devils did win the first one. And that brings another number 10 to the service line for Grand Falls, but unfortunately she hits into the net, and that will be a point Lady Devils. 4-3, Lady Devils have the lead as number 25, Brianna, comes to the service line. She's going to hit it. Grand Falls back row tries to field it. One more hit to get it over, and they do not get it over. So that will be point Lady Devils. And that'll be a two-point lead for the Lady Devils with number 25, Brianna, at the service line. Brianna doing an underhand serve. She hits it really high, and that's going to be an ace for the Lady Devils. 6-3 now is the score. Brianna serving nicely. She steps up to the line, underhanded serve, hits it really high. Played by the back row, Grand Falls, but too hot to handle for the back row, and that'll be a point Lady Devils, 7-3. Brianna still at the service line, hits it another good high ball. Grand Falls is able to play this one, and they do get it over. And it goes to Addison, to Arlie. Arlie gets it over. Now Grand Falls is going to have to, and they do. Played nice by Addison. We got a good rally here, and it falls short. Nice effort by both squads on this ball. And Rankin comes up victorious and gets the point, so that'll be an 8-3 game early in this second game of three in which the Lady Devils took the first one. And Brianna still at the service line, doing an outstanding job for the Lady Devils today. And she hits a little bit lower serve this time. It is fielded nicely by Grand Falls. They do almost get it over. Backcourt slam, but not high enough to go over the net. So let it be point Lady Devils. 9-3 is the score. And Brianna still at the service line. She hits it to the back row. It's played by the back row, and they're going to get it over nicely. Arlie plays it, but it goes in the net. Oh, it is 9-18. What a play by number 18, Addison. And they're still going back and forth as this rally continues, and it falls to the net. The play of the game so far right now is by number 18, Addison, digging the ball out of the net.
That was good.
And it's a 10-3 game as Brianna's still at the line. The Lady Devils are on top. Grandfall plays it, and they're going to just be short of getting it over, and that'll be point Lady Devils. 11-3 is the score, and Lady Devils won the first one. And Brianna's serving good. She's going to hit this one a little shorter. It's fielded by the front row into the net. Tough. Number 15 gives her best effort, hits the court, but is unable to get to it. And that'll be another point. Lady Devils 12-3 is the game. The score of the game with Brianna still at the service line. Brianna hits it. It's going to be fielded by the back row. Grand Falls is going to get this one over. They do. Brindley hits it. Brianna hustles for it, but is unable to get to it. And that will be point Grand Falls royalty. Now the score is 12-4. Lady Devils getting their early lead here in this second game. And bring up number 14 for Grand Falls. She's going to do an underhanded serve. She can hit it high, almost to the rafters. And it goes from Arley to Brianna to Brindley, and Brindley knocks it over nicely. Addison knocks it over. We got a good rally going here. But unfortunately, the point will go to Grand Falls Royalty. They hit it pretty deep on a nice play by the Cowgirls from Grand Falls. Now the score is 12-5 with number 14 still at the service line. This will be her second serve. And she's going to hit it underhanded. It's fielded in the back row by Brianna. Brianna gets it over. Grand Falls gets it over. And now it goes to Arley, to Addison, to Lesra. Lesra with a nice bump over the net. And it goes back to Rankin's side. Brianna, and then Brindley tries to punch it, but falls a little short. And we got some pretty good rallies going here back-to-back. And that's got a 12-6 game now, six-point spread. And with Rankin on top as number 14 heads to the service line. That's number 14. She hits it with no spin. Brianna gets it over the net. Grand Falls is going to hit it three times, but gets it over. Arley bumps it to Brindley. Brindley gets it over the net, back to Grand Falls, back to Rankin's side. Lezra back to Grand Falls side. And then Brindley spikes it with a nice spike, but it just barely goes out. And that will be a point, Grand Falls. Unfortunately, that ball went out because it's a nice hit by Brindley by the Lady Devils. 12-7 is now the score. Number 14 still at the service line for Grand Falls. Arley hits it to Addison. Addison back to Arley. Arley backcourt slam. What a backcourt spike there by number two, Arley. And that was a very aggressive hit. And that'll be a point for the Lady Devils. Oh. What did I miss there? I think they're going to give that point to Grand Falls. So
they did. I'm not sure what they called.
I think we might have touched the net, crossed the line or something, but the point will not go to the Lady Devils after that nice spike. It'll be Grand Falls, so that gives them 8 points and the Lady Devils 12, as number 14 is still serving. She can hit the back row. It's played nicely by Arley. Arley to Brianna. Brianna to Arley. Arley hits it deep with a lot of spin to it. But what a play by 14 for Grand Falls to keep that ball alive. Unfortunately, they can't get it over. But nice play by number 14 from Grand Falls. One-arm dig there. But point Lady Devils. Now it's a 13-8 game as Brindley goes to the service line. Number 24 for the Lady Devils. Brindley hits it deep and long. And they play it. And that's one of those balls you don't know whether to play or not. I think if she doesn't play it, it might be in. So you have to. So that'll be a point, Lady Devils, after a nice serve by 24, Brindley. Brindley's going to serve again, underhanded serve. She's going to knock it. Nice ball with a little spin. It had a little spice to it. And they're unable to handle that serve there, 15-8. You know, sometimes you think just because they're hitting it underhanded that it goes soft, but hers doesn't. They have a little spice to them. They spin a little bit. They're hard to hit from the back row. So now it's a 15-8 ball game. Brindley, number 24 for the Lady Devils at the service line. She served two nice ones already, and this will be a third one, and it'll be deep and out. And that'll be point Grand Falls. Now we have a 15-9 ball game here in the second game of three. Lady Devils were victorious in the first game, taking it 25-18. And now they have a pretty good lead here against Grand Falls in the second. Grand Falls serves it short. That'll be point Lady Devils 16-9 here. And like I said before, the stands are empty. It's loud in here. There's lots of people in here for a junior high game. And now we have number 18, Addison, serving it. She does a nice overhead serve, but hits it a little short. So that'll be 16-10. As number one heads to the service line for Grand Falls. And when she served before, she showed lots of power for the Cowgirls. And let's see if the Lady Devils can control her serves and get it back to the Grand Falls side of the net. Again, it's 16-10, six-point spread here in the second game. They're going to hit it. It's fielded by Addison. Addison to Arley. Arley to Lesra. Lesra pops it over, but it just falls out of bounds. But nicely played by number one on a tough ball. But unfortunately, Rankin does not get the point. The point will go to Grand Falls.
score should be 11-16.
Yeah, I think it's 11. I think Don's right. 11-16. They serve it, and it goes out of bounds. And so now it'll be 17-11. There we go. They got the score right. And coming to the line is number one, Alezra, for the Lady Devils. She can hit it nicely, fielded by the front row. And they do a nice hard slam, but Addison's there and digs it well. Arlie gets it over the net. Well played by the Lady Devils there. What great, a great dig by Addison, and then a great pop over the net by number two, Arlie. And that'll be point Lady Devils 18-11. Alezra's coming up to the line for her second attempt. And she's going to hit it, and it's going to be played by the back row there at Grand Falls. And number 14 gets it over the net. It's on the Rankin side. Arlie hits it to Giselle. Giselle hits it, but just wide. Falls out of bounds. And looks like we're going to have a timeout called by Grand Falls. We're back here at Grand Falls. It's 18-12 ball game. And they have a heck of a rally going on here, back and forth. I cannot keep up with it. But the Lady Devils end up getting the point after that nice rally back and forth. And nicely done by both teams here during that rally. But the point goes to Rankin. 19-12 is the score in the second game. Arlie is serving for the Lady Devils. She serves it well, and it's hit hard by Grand Falls, but goes just wide. And that will be a point, Lady Devils. 20-12 is the score. Lady Devils won the first game, so if they win this game, the match is over. 20-12, Arlie's at the service line. And she serves it, and it's going to be played by the front row, and they knock it over the net. Nicely done by the Lady Devils. And that'll be a point for Grand Falls Royalty Cowgirls. It'll be 20-13 is the score. And there's some pitchforks now in the crowd. I don't see any Mohawks, though, but I do see some pitchforks. It's good to see some Red Devil spirit. I love it. All right, so here we go. That's number 12, Giselle, with a great serve. And that'll be too much to handle for Grand Falls, and that will be a point for the Lady Devils. And that brings the score to 22-13 with Giselle at the line. Let's see if the Lady Devils can close this game out and win the match. Giselle hits it, and it goes over the net, sneaks over like a cat on a hot fence, I think Boo Boo would say. And that will be a point. Lady Devils 23-13, 2 points for closing out this match, which is Giselle at the line. Giselle's going to serve it, and it's going to hit just the top of the net and fall a little short. And so it'll be 23-14, and Grand Falls Royalty number 10 will go to the service line. And she's going to serve it, and it's going to go into the net, and that's going to bring up game point for the Lady Devils as Brindley goes to the line 24-14. 1 point away from winning the match. She serves it. It's played by the back row. Grand Falls is going to get it over. And Rankin sends it by, right back their way. Then Brianna sends it back into no man's land. That will be the match. What a play there by the Lady Devils. And they win. They are victorious. 25-14, winning this game, this match in two games back-to-back. 25-18 and then 25-14, the Lady Devils are victorious.